The PYFL presents All-Star Youth Football at its finest. They're some of the most talented young players in Southern California, if not the nation. And on this day, they meet on the gridiron in the high desert, Palmdale High School to be exact, in a North versus South format. In this contest, it's the best 11-year-olds in the region. Let's meet the Midget All-Stars.
My name is Jordan White. I play for the Burbank Vikings. My position is cornerback, and my favorite player is RG3.
My name is Deontay Caldwell. I play for the Lancaster Jets. My position is running back, and my favorite athlete is De'Anthony Thomas.
Number four, Drew Watts, is a 5'3", 118-pound back from the Highland Bulldogs. He's the rare talent who's a threat to score every time he touches the ball. Number five, Cameron Warr, scored 8 touchdowns for the Santa Clarita Chiefs. The 5'3", 93-pound back was voted his team's hard-nosed player of the year.
My name is Dalt Wassey. I play for the Palmdale Falcons. My position is wide receiver and free safety, and my favorite athlete is Marshawn Lynch.
My name is Dalen Bright, Lancaster Jets, quarterback and running back. Favorite player is Deion Sanders.
My name is Marcus Richardson. I'm from the Highland Bulldogs. I'm running back, receiver, and punt return, and defensive back. My favorite player is Deion Sanders and Walter Payton.
My name is Elias Larry. I play quarterback for the Highland Bulldogs. My favorite athlete is Russell Wilson.
I'm Cameron Scott. I play for the Bulldogs. I play safety and quarterback. And my favorite player is Cam Chancellor.
My name is Derek Harvey III, and I play for the Eagles. I play quarterback, running back, and linebacker. And my favorite player is Steve Smith.
My name is Eric Williams. I play for the Jets. My high position is halfback, running back, and cornerback. My favorite athlete is Richard Sherman.
My name is Danny Rodriguez. I play for the Valley Bengals. I was a QB. And my favorite athlete is Colin Kaepernick.
My name is Isaiah Navarro. I play for the Rebels, and I play defensive end, tackle, and wide receiver. And my favorite athlete is Michael Jordan.
My name is Owen Garber. I play for the Valley West Ravens. My position is defensive end and left tackle. My favorite athlete is Bo Jackson, J.J. Watt, and Clay Matthews.
Hi, my name is Kayla Quiones. I play for the Midget or Seminoles. My position is middle linebacker and fullback. My favorite player is Ray Lewis.
My name is Gary Johnson. I play for the Highland Bulldogs, play defensive end. My favorite athlete is Deion Sanders.
My name is Brody Vargas. I play for the Highland Bulldogs, and I play defensive end, and I don't have a favorite athlete.
My name is Devin Cephas. I play for the Valley Bengals. My position is middle linebacker, and my favorite athlete is Troy Palmalo.
My name is Chad Stitch. I play for the Santa Clarita Valley Apaches. My number is 44. I play middle linebacker, and my favorite NFL player is J.J. Watt.
My name is Ryan Rossi. I play for the Santa Clarita Chiefs. I'm nose guard, and my favorite athlete is Peyton Manning.
Hi, my name is Hadi Mahaz. I play for Santa Clarita Seminoles. I play tackle, guard, center, linebacker, D-end, tackle on defense. My favorite athlete is Larry Fitzgerald.
My name's Tristan Scott. I play for the Santa Clarita Chiefs, and my position is left guard, and I look up to J.J. Watt.
My name is Tony Gutierrez. I play for the Valley Bengals. My position is the center, and my favorite athlete is Cahill Mack.
Hi, my name is Lonzel Francisco. I'm from the Bulldogs, and my position is nose guard. My favorite athlete is Jamal Charles.
Hi, my name is Jackson Sine. I play for the Santa Clarita Chiefs. I play right guard, and I love Russell Wilson.
My name is Andrew Lopez for the Palmdale Falcons. I play left guard. My favorite athlete is Kobe Bryant.
My name is Anthony Oxis, and I play for the Midget Chiefs, and my position is center, and my favorite player is Jason Witten.
My name is Swanson Nenner. I play for the Highland Bulldogs. I'm receiver and corner, and my favorite athlete is Walter Payton.
Ezekiel Larry. Highland Bulldogs, defensive tackle. My favorite athlete is Leonard Williams.
My name is Britt Buchanan. I play for the Lancaster Jets. My position is defensive tackle, and my favorite player is Ray Rice for the Baltimore Ravens.
Knowles Williams is a 5'4", 90-pound receiver from North Oxnard Gray. He had 7 touchdowns this year and always has a positive attitude.
My name is Drew Norris. I play for the Ventura Packers. I'm receiver and running back, and my favorite player is Marshawn Lynch.
My name is Devin Alpio. I play for the Oxnard Panthers. I play inside and outside linebacker, and my favorite athlete is Colin Kaepernick.
Hello, my name is Jake East. I play for the Agoura Chargers. I play wide receiver, and my favorite athlete is Von Miller.
My name is Adrian Perez. I play for the Ventura Packers. My position is nose guard, and my favorite athlete is Marcus Ware for Bronco.
Hi, my name is Andrew Lopez. I play for Oxnard Panthers. The positions that I play are safety, corner, kick return, punt return, and my favorite player is DeSean Jackson.
Hi, my name is Declan Hamworker. I play for the Camarillo Roadrunners. I play QB and outside linebacker. My favorite player is Peyton Manning.
My name is Daniel Duran. I play for the Ventura Packers, quarterback, and my favorite player is Marcus Mariota.
My name is Scott Detweiler. I play for the Newry Park Steelers. I play receiver, and my favorite player is Braxton Miller from the Ohio State University.
My name is Poi Aina. I play for the Oxnard Warriors. I play linebacker, and I like Troy Polamalu.
Jake Andrew Giroux, Simi Valley Vikings. Safety. And LaDainian Thomason.
My name is Eric Marshall. I play for the Camarillo Roadrunners. I'm the center, and my favorite player is Brett Favre.
Hi, my name is Jack Stonehouse. I play for the Thousand Oaks Titans. I play punter and kicker, and I like Cody Kessler.
My name is Nico Nares. I play for the Ventura Packers. My position is middle linebacker, and my favorite player is Bo Jackson.
Hi, my name is Christian Middleton. I play for the Camarillo Roadrunners Blue. My position is running back, and my favorite player is LeSean McCoy.
Hi, my name is Titus Hutchison, and I play for the Ventura Packers, and I play defensive end, and my favorite player is Michael Vick.
Hi, my name is Isaiah Aragon. I play for the Ventura Packers. I play wide receiver, and my favorite player is Calvin Johnson.
My name is Justin Perez. I play middle linebacker for the Santa Barbara Sharks, and my favorite player is Justin Tuck.
Hi, my name is Ryan Banning. I play for the Agoura Oak Park Chargers. My position is right guard, and my favorite player is Jamal Charles.
My name is Jesse Valenzuela. I play for the Ventura Packers. I'm a running back, and my favorite player is Henry Fernandez.
My name is Peyton Casillas. I play for Thousand Oaks Titans, and I play outside linebacker, and my favorite athlete is Demaryius Thomas.
My name is Nathan Davis. I play for the Agoura Chargers. My position is left guard, and my favorite player is Russell Wilson.
My name is Tanilo Lamalu. I play for Ventura Packers. I play corner, and my favorite player is Odell Beckham Jr.
I'm Mitchell Nowoska. I play for the Thousand Oaks Titans. I am a guard, and my favorite player is Tony Romo.
Hi, my name is Benny Rundon. I play for the Thousand Oaks Titans Midget Division. I play tight end, and my favorite player is me.
My name is Riley Banducci. I play for the Agoura Chargers. I play defensive end and left tackle. My favorite player is Marcus Mariota.
Hi, my name is Dylan Randall, and I play for Ventura Packers Midget Division, and I play left tackle on the offense, and my favorite player is Ryan Matthews.
Hi, my name is Cade Brady. I play for Thousand Oaks Titans. I play defensive tackle, and my favorite player is Clay Matthews.
Hello, my name is Isaiah Panapa. I play for Thousand Oaks Titans. I am defensive end and offensive tackle. My favorite player is me.
My name is Trevor Fletcher. I play defensive end and wide receiver for the Simi Valley Vikings, and my favorite player is Jamal Charles.
My name is Matthew Cortez. I play for the Ventura Packers. I play left guard or left tackle, and my favorite player is Patrick Willis.
My name is Max Messina. I play for the North Oxnard Warriors Midget Red. My position is nose guard, and my favorite player is Calvin Johnson.
My name is Isaac Garcia. I play tight end for the Camarillo Roadrunners Midget Blue, and my favorite player is Vernon Davis.
And now to our announcers.
Welcome to Palmdale High School for our PYFL All-Star Game. The Midget Division, the South against the North. My name is Randy Rosenblum with Toy Cook. On the sideline is Shauna Shippen. We're excited about this one. The South is going to get the football first. They have two outstanding young boys back deep. Deonce Caldwell, number 2, and number 7, DeLon Bright. Toy, this is going to be a lot of fun today.
It's going to be a fantastic day. We got great weather.
beautiful surroundings. I'm really looking forward to seeing these kids play.
These are 11 and 12-year-old young men. Terrific players, all-stars. And they will showcase their skills today. The South receiving. Kicking off for the North is Jack Stonehouse from the Thousand Oaks Titans. Renowned for his great kickoffs. Taken by one of the up men. Running out across the 50-yard line and down the sideline. What a start for the South.
Touchdown.
How about a touchdown? Oliver Big O Hanlon of the Valley Bengals. He gave the block, and taking it in was DeWitt Wassie.
That's the way you want to start an all-star game. Get the opening kick, break a couple tackles, make it all the way to the end zone. First time you touch the ball, is there anything better than that post-Thanksgiving?
No. And DeWitt, 5'5 and 90 pounds, got a terrific block downfield from Big O Hanlon and took it in for the score.
Well, and one of our notes on him is that he's a great possession receiver with great hands, but it looked like he's a tough receiver to tackle because he broke a lot of tackles going on for that touchdown.
And Toy, of course, specialty teams are tough to get that right with limited practices. So that was a great opportunity and a score for the South. The kick is away and wide to the right. Eric Williams of the Lancaster Jets was the one trying to drive it through. So it remains 6-0, and we only played 16 seconds.
Once again, you know, you come to these all-star games, and as a kid, you dream about making plays like that and to get the opening kick, break some tackles. DeWitt Wassie, who we did talk to before the game.
Now, blockers were downfield, and Wassie made it happen. And he did a great job tight roping the far sideline and not going out of bounds when there was a lot of traffic near him. So in just that 16-second span, the South on the board early. Some fireworks.
Real fireworks. Before we could even get settled. It's a good thing we got up here on time.
Yeah, we better be on time. We're going to have a full day of football here at Palmdale High School. Four different divisions, and again, this is the midgets. So the South will be kicking off to the North. Maybe we'll have a return back the other way.
South side has already.
Young boys are so excited to play today. Glorious conditions in Palmdale.
North side looking to answer.
Eric Williams will be kicking off for the South. And we'll see what the North can do with the football for the first time this morning. And it is a morning game. It was a 10 a.m. kickoff. And again, delightful conditions. And no wind at all. Another short kick. Taken at the 35-yard line. And with it is Jake East. East brings it back out to the 37. And he was tackled by, you guessed it, DeWitt Wassie.
Yeah, Jake East. Should have been going north. Looked like he was going west.
Lawrence is the head coach. Lawrence Larry of the South. Rich Marshall from the Camarillo Roadrunners is the head coach of the North Midgets. First down, 36-yard line. We'll see our first play from scrimmage today.
Everyone, please relax about the scoreboard. We're taking care of it.
First 27 seconds of action. Both these teams will run a multitude of offenses, even though they've had limited practices. Quarterback, and he's a good one. That's Daniel Duran. And they run the football out across the 40 to the 44-yard line. Christian Middleton from the Camarillo Roadrunners, and we were told he would start. Middleton has went over 1,000 yards rushing in the league this year. He really came on.
Yeah, you want to talk about taking the next step. says he's tripled his production from last season. So if you had over 1,000 yards, does that mean he only had 300 yards last year?
That still isn't bad, right, Toy?
That is not bad. He's an all-star.
Third down and three. North down early 6-0. Middleton again, bouncing to the outside. That's a nice run and a first down. Flag behind the play, and the ball's on the ground. South believes they have it. They've recovered the football.
All-star games are all about big plays. We open up with the kickoff return, and then we get a quick fumble. Let's see what the South does with this opportunity at the 50-yard line.
Great start for the South. They get the wonderful kickoff return for the touchdown from DeWitt Wassey. And now they take over at the 49-yard line after the turnover. Elias Larry of the Highland Bulldogs is the head of this offense as he's the quarterback. Speaking of head, his dad, Lawrence Larry, is the head coach. And his brother's also on the team. Zeke Larry. And they'll start with a run play. Drew Watts from the Highland Bulldogs. He's 5'3 and 118 pounds.
Yeah, he's a kid with, you know, explosive, rare combination of speed, size, and strength, and we saw that on that little twist. Looked like he got a little jitterbug in him.
And he got to the point of attack in a hurry.
A little Reggie Bush-like. I mean, it was quick, a nice turn move. Looks like he can be explosive. This is going to be an interesting game.
That was Drew Watts.
Second down and seven. Ball sitting at the 46-yard line of the North. South with a touchdown up on
second
the board,
down.
Leading 6-0 with 9:40 to play in the first quarter, and they are playing 12-minute quarters. High school rules here today. Caldwell bouncing to the outside, has the 40 to the 39-yard line, and very close to a first down for Deontay Caldwell.
That was Deontay Caldwell of the Jets.
Apui of the Oxnard Panthers, the linebacker, made the tackle.
Yeah, Devin Apui from the Oxnard Panthers. Good job running sideline to sideline to make that tackle.
There is a marker down at the 45-yard line. Charles Cameron is our referee. He says holding offense. So that nice run by Caldwell is nullified.
Yeah, now we know why he was able to turn the corner. Someone was holding.
Takes it back to the 45-yard line of the South. What you love about these All-Star games, not only great players, great attitudes. You know, when we talked to many of these kids earlier today, Toy, they were gentlemen, young boys, well-mannered, well-spoken.
Well-spoken, well-coached, and out to have a good time. The biggest thing about coming to these All-Star games is to have fun. And the kids were talking about what you have for Thanksgiving, and did you see the game yesterday? So it was good to see that they're happy to be out here.
Second down. We'll call it 16. Larry's pass. Wassey went up. Couldn't bring that one in. Excellent coverage on the corner by Jake Turu. Now, he spells his name T-H-E-R-O-U-X, but it's not Thoreau. It's Turu.
It's Turu, and if I would have bet $100 that it was Thoreau, as I told you, and he quickly corrected us that it's Turu. And that was excellent coverage by Jake Turu of the Simi Valley Vikings.
Looks to showcase excellent cover skills on that island. He's matched up one-on-one against Swanson Nunnery, who's got terrific speed. Third down, 16. South 6-0 lead. See what Larry can do here. Into traffic. That's a nice catch at the 45-yard line. That was not an easy grab. There was two defenders in the area. Good throw by Larry. And a wonderful catch.
Pass complete to number 6, DeWitt Wassey.
DeWitt Wassey, who made that grab, off to a fabulous start here.
Yeah, DeWitt Wassey at 5'5". Looks like little Randy Moss out there. Went up high, got it at its highest point. Made a fantastic catch between two defenders. He looks like he's a player.
Thank you.
already has that long kickoff return for the 6 points for the South. Certainly makes it more manageable. So far, but there's another marker or not? I think this one might be coming back. We had a legal shift. And despite the great work of Wasi, it's going to get more difficult for the South to overcome down in distance.
Well, and a great throw by Elias Larry. For you, which surprisingly for these kids to be able to throw the ball like that, I was shocked. I was thinking more of a run game, but as you can see, they're running a trips professional offense.
It's amazing how sophisticated they are early. That one intended for the swift-footed wide receiver. That's Swanson Nunnery. We talked about him from the Bulldogs of Highland. Highly competitive, talented wide receiver.
Well, all the nunneries that I've known have been incredibly fast. So if he's like the rest of the nunneries, expect big things from him.
Well, they're going to have to punt it away, and it will be Swanson Nunnery to do the kicking. He's a very enthusiastic young guy and a real leader for the South squad. So the North is going to get it back, trailing 6-0 in the first quarter, 7:15 to play. Nice kick that's down by Caldwell at the 41-yard line, and no chance for a return for Andrew Lopez.
And the North side will come back out on offense.
So here comes the North, trailing by a touchdown, 6-0, with 7:09 to play in the opening quarter. With Toy Cook and Shauna Shippen, my name is Randy Rosenblum. Glad you're with us from Palmdale High School, home of the Falcons, on a beautiful morning in Southern California. This is PYFL football, midget division, 11 and 12-year-olds. And it's amazing, really, Toy, how well these teams execute, considering one team had two practices and the other squad had four.
Yeah, earlier we got a legal shift, and I was expecting a little bit more of that with the limited amount of practice time. But in lieu of what's happened so far, this is still looks like a really good game.
We do have a flag down. It'll be stepped off against the South. Takes it out to the 46-yard line, so it'll be first and five.
On the field before the snack.
Had an extra body out there.
That's what happens when you only have a couple practices.
Daniel Duran, second back through. Jesse Valenzuela with the carry. Wears number 28, alternating with Christian Middleton and Jesse Valenzuela from Ventura White. 4'9". He's not a weakling, even though he's 98 pounds.
By number 28 of Ventura White, Jesse Valenzuela.
Second down and one. Ball close to the 50-yard line. North looking to erase a 6-0 deficit. Right up the middle. Middleton weaving through traffic down to the 43 and has a first down.
Yeah, nice run by Middleton. Great block by the South. Or actually, that would be the North team. Nice interior blocking. Created a hole for Mr. Middleton.
Matthew Cortez, the offensive tackle from Ventura White, with a beautiful block up front.
First and 10.
Ball sitting at the 44, so the North threatening here with 6 minutes to play in the first quarter. Duran with that rifle arm. That was a good throw, a little bit too low, but well thrown. Out on the flanks, wanted Noel Williams.
Yeah, Noel Williams from the North Oxnard grades, 5'4", 90 pounds. This year he had five TDs in the air and two on the ground, making him a dynamic multi-talented player.
Second down and 10. So far, some pretty good balance here. They haven't completed the passes, but they're certainly keeping the South on their toes with the ability to throw the football, the lineup and an eye. Again, it's the second back through and no running room. Casey Middleton hit in his tracks. Terrific defensive play by Ryan Rossi of the Santa Clarita Valley Chiefs, 5'5 and 130 pounds. He recovered four fumbles this season.
That usually means you're a guy that always knows where the ball is, and as we saw right there, he found the ball and put him down. Nice tackle.
Third down. North needs 11 yards. Need to get to the 34-yard line of the South for their first down. Play fake by Duran. He's pressured. Forced to run. That's a great effort. Not going to pick up the first down, but you love the feet of number nine, quarterback Daniel Duran. He made something happen.
Daniel Duran, a southpaw from Ventura White, 5'2", 125. That's a good job of scrambling, taking the opportunity where there was nothing and then turning it into something to give themselves a chance on fourth down here.
Certainly more manageable on fourth down. Fourth down, they need 6.5 yards. They'll go for it. Of course, in youth football, you'll see a lot of coaches gamble on fourth down. Don't have quite as much faith in the punting game. Here it is, fourth down and 6.5. Bouncing to the outside, Christian Middleton turns the corner. First down yardage. And chased out of bounds by Drew Watts.
And 21.
Fantastic run by Christian Middleton. That looked a little bit like the Stanford-UCLA game, unfortunately for Shauna Shippen, our sideline reporter, who went to UCLA. But great off-tackle run. Had the speed to get the first down.
Yeah, but Toy, you were a super player at Stanford. You got to be thrilled with the Cardinals' performance in SoCal.
In light of what the Stanford's gone through this year, to come to the Rose Bowl and extend their win streak to 7 over UCLA and to watch all those fans stream out of there in the third quarter, it was fantastic.
Spoken like a happy alumnus. First down at the 31-yard line. Duran going up top. Open receiver. This is a touchdown for Aragon. Isaiah Aragon
from the Ventura White. Fantastic throw and catch. Unbelievable skill for such a young age.
How about that throw by Daniel Duran? That was on time and on the money.
I'm speechless. That was like a great throw on stride for a touchdown.
Something about the touch of a southpaw. Well, this southpaw is playing for the North. It's a 6-6 ball game. Looking for the lead. He's throwing again. Incomplete. We're going to remain tied at 6 apiece. He was looking for Williams.
In the first quarter, your score.
So at just above 4 minutes to play, opening quarter, we're even at 6 apiece. It's been a well-played opening quarter.
It has been a well-played opening quarter. Great job on that play by number nine, Marcus Richardson, playing corner to stop that slant. This is going to be a good game, like we said earlier. This is both all-stars. These are the best players from their respective leagues and teams. And so far, so good.
South and North knotted in a 6-6 tie. The touchdown for the South was a brilliant kickoff return by DeWitt Wassey. And then that beautiful touchdown aerial to Isaiah Aragon, thrown by quarterback Daniel Duran. What a year he had with the Packers.
We appreciate you, bro.
Playing for the Ventura White today. His Packer team went 10-1. That's a fine-looking quarterback.
The kick is away.
DeLon Bright. And DeLon Bright near side. We may have another kickoff for a touchdown. DeLon Bright takes it to the house.
Number 7.
There is a marker behind the play.
DeLon Bright.
Too bad. Just like at the UCLA Stanford game, another flag on the field. But it still does not diminish what DeLon Bright, shone really bright on that run. Look for him to do big things because obviously he was the quickest, fastest player on the field. So if I and the South. I'm trying to get him the ball.
Unfortunately, the South was offside, so that will take the score off the board. We'll try it again, but you're right. That doesn't diminish what we saw from DeLon Bright. Noted as a defensive player, but certainly on that kick return, showed us great wheels. Well, it's fun to see these big plays.
Well, it is an all-star game. You know, obviously, typically, most of these kids are the fastest kids in their league. They get one crease, and it's over.
Well, DeLon Bright, after charging downfield a good 80 yards, is back deep again, joined by Deontay Caldwell. Caldwell averaged 3 touchdowns a game during the regular season.
Well, and you know what the worst part about this is? The kickoff team was offsides, so they have to re-kick it. So it wasn't actually the South's fault. So it's a good thing that the North was offsides.
Isaiah Navarro from the West Valley Rebels will tee it up. What you love about Isaiah Navarro, he's a 4.0 student.
And the kick is away.
Same direction, different return artist. Excellent field position for the South across the 50-yard line. Returning the ball for the South was Marcus Richardson.
But you know what's really interesting? The South just lost 50 yards because the North was offsides. How do you like those apples?
Well, the South will try to overcome that infraction.
Setting up for some offensive work.
3:41 to play in the first quarter. His youth games are run well. This lead official, Charles Cameron, has said start the clock, and it's running 3:34, 3:33 left opening quarter. Coming back into the lineup is DeLon Bright, number 7. Quarterback has been Elias Larry. I also like Danny D-Rod Rodriguez, quarterback. He'll play extensively today. And Bright puts it on the ground. Looked like it was recovered by Drew Watts, number 4.
That was a fumble on that play, but it was recovered by number 4, Drew Watts.
So the South doing a nice job after the fumble getting back on the ball.
Well, there's something happened with the center quarterback exchange. Larry was fumbling the ball around, and luckily Drew Watts was able to recover that fumble, because otherwise the North was going to have really good field position.
DeLon Bright has come into quarterback. I mean, it was Bright that put it on the ground. So new quarterback in there late in this first quarter. Deep pitch. Drew Watts, another flag is down. I like this guy. He is strong with great moves. Back to the original line of scrimmage. But there's a yellow flag behind the play at the 43-yard line.
We got a laundry basket.
Yeah. These referees, to their credit, I don't care if it's the pros or college, they're treating this game as seriously, and they're calling everything.
Holding foul will wipe out a terrific run by Drew Watts. South in the blue and white. The white and black uniforms of the Northern Stars. This is our midget game. Again, these are boys 11 and 12 years of age. I do like number 4, Drew Watts. He looks like a physical running back.
Physical, in the mold of, say, an Adrian Peterson.
Well, the book on him, he's got a rare combination of speed, size, and strength. We'll see if number 4 will be a major factor before this
second
one's over.
For the South.
Got to go all the way to the 39-yard line of the North for the first down, and they're at their 33. Bright calls his own number, breaking a tackle. That's a beautiful job, taking it out to the 41-yard line.
That was seven, DeLon Bright.
Well, we saw DeLon Bright on that kick return go the distance, and he showed skills there.
Yeah, I think that any time he's back there, you know, in the pros and in college, we call that a wildcat. So anytime he gets back there, you got to get ready.
Isaiah Panapa with the stop. Played for the Titans of Thousand Oaks.
Dominant run and pass blocker who has great mobility for his size, which he showed anytime that you can get, you know, DeLon Bright down.
Derek Harvey has come into the offense of the South. He wears number 12. With 40.1 seconds left in the quarter, the South wants a timeout on third down and very long.
We got a timeout on the field.
South offense back out there, third down and long. Final 40 seconds of the opening quarter in a 6-6 tie. The North third and the down. South in our Midget All-Star game. Offense. Incomplete. Fourth down. Tremendous pressure on the quarterback.
Pass intended for number six.
The white shirts were on the move. That was a pass intended for the touchdown maker, DeWitt Wasik.
Yeah, Isaiah Panapa from the Thousand Oaks Titans at 5'6", 151. Looks like a monster out there, and he just put a monster rush on.
Well, with this kind of down and distance, it's fourth down and about 20. They will punt the football.
Fourth down. This is a noise making.
Andrew Lopez
get involved in the game.
Drifting back to return.
Both sides should be backing up
those Eric
squads.
Williams will punt it away. Andrew Lopez, great defensive back, outstanding return guy. It's over Lopez's head, but watch this. Andrew has great skills. Look at that move. Well, that was some move in the spin cycle.
Yeah. You need some bleach with that move. I mean, that was some quickness.
Andrew Lopez.
4'10 and 86 pounds, and Andrew Lopez, unbelievable return guy in the final 15 seconds.
Left in the first quarter.
He's fun to watch.
No, really fun to watch. What I'm really interested is, if you're from Oxnard, there's a family called the Ina family, and all three, two brothers and a cousin, are playing. So it's interesting to see how they're going to dominate this the offensive line of scrimmage.
By the way, Daniel Duran is the only quarterback for the North, so he figures to go the distance. And this is Middleton, straight up the middle. And that'll be the final play of the first quarter. So after the first 12 minutes, your score is the South 6 and the North 6. This is our Midget Division game in the PYFL.
Third at the Highland Eagles with some friends.
Going into the second quarter here at Palmdale High School, home of the Falcons. The wind's starting to kick up in our 6-6 tie.
Balloons and face painting.
Our Midget Division football game. With the football, the North in the white, South in the blue.
Shout-outs available.
Hey, they have the stock ball, right?
At its second down and 8 to go. Jake East in motion. And Duran throwing for East, too high and nearly picked off by Deontay Caldwell. Third down and 8.
No, good coverage by Deontay Caldwell. Usually, you know, when you're a left-handed quarterback, you usually want to roll to your left. He rolled to the right. The wide side of field was a little high, but good effort.
I do like this quarterback, though. He threw a beautiful touchdown pass earlier in the game, Daniel Duran, and he hit his splendid wide receiver, Isaiah Aragon, for a 30-yard score. That's how they got their 6 on the board and tied it. After an early, and I mean early, in the first 16 seconds, a kick return by DeWitt Wassey.
Third down.
For the South. Third down and long. They'll go the conservative route. And the South able to bottle up the play. And it'll bring up fourth down and long. Trying to get through there was Jesse Valenzuela. But Maz got him. Hadi Maz from the Santa Clarita Valley Seminoles, the defensive end.
Yeah, Hadi Maz at 5'5", 125. He was second on his team in tackles with one forced fumble.
Hear him cheering in the background is Brent Buchanan, who is also in on that play, who plays for the Lancaster Jets. And the Buchanan family is here in Mass.
Represented very well. He's 5'2", 105 pounds, a physical run blocker and a great pass protector. Got in on that tackle.
Fourth down punt. Bright gets a nice hop. Looking for a block. Find some room. DeLon Bright again. This time I don't see a penalty flag. DeLon Bright has scored a touchdown.
As I said earlier, he looks like one of the fastest kids on the field. All he needs is some open space. And DeLon Bright with a second touchdown. And you're right, there wasn't a flag this time. That had to be at least a 60-yard punt return.
Well, they found something in DeLon Bright. What a return by number 7. Again, during the regular season, he was noted for his defensive work and a lot of sacks, plays everywhere on the field. They were comparing him to Troy Polamalu on defense, but his offensive skills in this All-Star game has been splendid.
Yeah, I think I would compare him to DeSean Jackson, more so than Troy Polamalu. And DeLon Bright, I think what I mean, he obviously has the nickname of Bright Lights because he's playing like it right now.
Swanson Nunnery counting up the bodies out there, and they are going to try to kick it. They needed one extra guy to come out there, which was Keeler Quiñones.
So we're setting up for a point after kick.
We have an offside penalty, so even though this one isn't going to get there, they'll get another opportunity.
We got a flag on the play.
North came charging across. So do you go for the two-point conversion here?
I think if you're getting half the yardage to the goal, you got to go for the two-point conversion.
Chad Stitch has checked in. An athlete, plays a lot of different positions for the South Stars.
A little confusion.
Yeah, I'm not sure if they know. Still looks like they're going to kick it. Yeah, they will. One's got a chance, but just underneath the crossbar.
Just short, no good.
Temple Elias Larry tried it. Good effort, though, and it's 12-6.
Yeah, fantastic effort, and I'm happy to see that they're trying to kick extra points because that's an integral part of the game, and I like seeing it at this level.
You know, that's something that can be overlooked here. You know, yeah, they had half the distance to the goal, and maybe they should have gone for two. But it's about teaching these kids skills.
That's right. You know, in the PYFL and in the Pop Warner, it's all about the development of the kids. So fantastic job by the coach to continue, even in an All-Star game, to work on their special teams. And that would be Lawrence Larry, who's the head coach of the Highland Bulldogs.
Well, the South leads for the second time today. They led 6-0, tied at 6, and now they reclaim the advantage at 12-6. .10:45 left in the half, and Eric Williams, and all the kicking chores for the South, has been busy this morning. This weather, we're coming in on December. What great weather we've had in Southern California. Got to be thrilled to play these All-Star games in this climate.
It's an onside kick.
It's a short kick taken by the up man, Nico Narez, from the Ventura White.
Was recovered by
and I love the form. He scooped it up beautifully.
Yeah, you know, it's funny. He's in the front line, which typically those are big guys. But at the All-Star game, everyone is an All-Star. Nico Narez from the Ventura White picked it up and started running. And the thing about Nico is, you know, he's a top linebacker in the division. Great football IQ, always in the right spot. And he was right there.
Well, the North will start from their 49-yard line. And keep an eye on number 23, Isaiah Aragon, that outstanding, tall, quick wide receiver with the great hands. Caught their touchdown earlier today. 12-6 South leads. They're on defense. The delay goes nowhere and, in fact, loses yardage.
Was made by 54.
Hadi Maz again on defense. Number 54 is a stud on D.
Yeah. Hadi Maze or Hadi Maz, whatever way you want to call it.
I got a shout out.
Tough kid. Tough, strong, fast, great play by him.
This one will go out to the Team North coaches. Thank you for all that.
North
you
needs
do.
12 yards on second down. Duran's pass is deflected, but it got to the outside and caught. Pickup of just a couple. Swanson Nunnery on the coverage. Got to be very careful when the ball's on the flanks to Aragon. Third down and 9. Wide receiver Knowles Williams also back in, wearing number 1. He's to the near side, lined up against Eric Williams. So one Williams defending another.
Yeah, and on that play, Ezekiel Larry almost got to the quarterback, number 90.
Duran in trouble, breaks one tackle. No chance. There was too many of the blue shirts.
Yeah, once again, Hadi Maz caused the little disruption at the point of the attack, forced him to go inside. These guys are playing ball.
So a couple specialty team scores for the South. A punt return by DeLon Bright for a touchdown and a kick return for a score by DeWitt Wassey.
Right, so
and those guys are back deep. And they're also joined by Deonce Caldwell.
But this shout-out goes to
Jack Stonehouse again will punt.
Let's do this.
I might start kicking away from these return guys. They're all very good for the South.
And especially when they got two guys back there. So it's not like you can, you know, directional kick. Which they're nice kick.
They did a great job of pinpointing it to the sideline away from Deonce Caldwell, who had no chance to get to it.
And the Palmdale AD has good hands.
I really love the speed that we're seeing from the South.
Yeah, I think both teams really, but what I'm really more impressed with that rugby-style kick was the ability to directional kick and change the field position.
So proud of you, Big Isaac.
Yeah, Jack Stonehouse from the Thousand Oaks Titan. And it's so funny. Both teams usually, like, you're the quarterback, the kicker, the punter, but both these teams has designated kickers and punters.
Another north side shout-out.
It'll be a little bit longer field for the South
number
with 8 minutes to play in our opening half.
We're proud of you, son.
DeLon Bright will stay in at quarterback. He took over in the last couple minutes of the first quarter.
I didn't forget about you over here.
Elias Larry started as the quarterback for the Midget South team.
I got some shout-outs for you, too. They coming.
First down and 10.
Speaking of the South Side, it's first down.
Drew Watts. This time he stalled at the point of attack. Adrian Perez with the hit. Adrian was to wear number 85, but the uniform didn't fit, so they gave him number 6. So you'll see number 6 in the middle of that defensive front.
Yeah, that's right. You're not used to seeing a number 6, but as big as he is, 5'7", 140 pounds, big aggressive defensive end that has speeds and hands of a much smaller player, but he didn't need it there.
Second down and nearly 13 to go for the South. Jet sweep with Wasi. Can only reach the 20-yard line.
By number 6, DeWitt Wasi. He met up with the North.
That is a very popular play these days when you bring the sweeper around for the jet sweep.
Well, like you said, with the South speed that they have, if they can turn that corner, there's a lot of opportunity for them to take it all the way down. So this is going to be interesting. If they don't get this third down conversion, it looks like the North is going to get good field position. So this is a big third down right now.
Opportunity to see San Pedro recently, and they call their wide receivers sweepers because they run that jet sweep all the time. They don't even consider them wideouts. They're sweepers. Third down and 11. Bright. Takes it upfield, runs hard, but he's well shy of the first down. He needs about 8 more, so it'll be fourth down and 8. But Bright so quick, but he is denied that time, and the South's going to punt the football.
Yeah, I think Trevor Fletcher and Matthew Cortez were in on that tackle. Trevor Fletcher from the Simi Valley Vikings and Matthew Cortez from Ventura White in on that tackle.
So that's a good stand by the North Midget team. And they do figure to get great field position here.
Southside getting set for a punt.
They started a little early, so this one will come back. The gunner on the outside was racing downfield. That was Deontay Caldwell.
Yeah, and I think we have, is it Swanson Nunnery? Is he our punter?
Yes, he is.
Yeah, you have to watch out. If it's a bad snap or a fumble snap, he has the ability to probably take off and run it for the first down.
For the South Side.
At least Deontay got his money's worth. He shot downfield for about, he was 3 seconds ahead of the play. 10 yards downfield.
Bulldog Nation and South Side all day. Let's go, boys.
That hit one of the team's players for the North. South believes it should be their ball. I think that's the right call. It went off of one of the North players, deflected to the ground, and the South gets it back.
Yeah, there's nothing you can do on a play when Nunnery hit like a one iron, low to the ground, hit one of the North players, and South gets the ball right there.
Rory McIlroy or Tiger Woods couldn't have done it any better than that.
Coming under the trees and out of the bushes.
It becomes a turnover. So the South fortunate here. It would have given the North the ball right about the 30-yard line.
Yeah, they get an extra set of downs, but, you know, there's nothing that you can do if you're a North player. You're blocking your guy and you get hit with a, you know, like I said, a one iron about 3 feet off the ground.
First down and 10. They scrimmage from the 23-yard line. There's that sweep.
Ooh.
War. Cameron War. That's a nice effort across the 25, out near the 27-yard line.
But did you see that crack back block by DeWitt Wasi to spring Cameron War? 5'3", 93, 8 touchdowns this season. War has been selected as our hard-nosed player of the year.
He's got the perfect name, doesn't he? War, to be hard-nosed.
You're too quick for me today.
I try to be.
You're always quick.
Well, we'll see if the South can matriculate it the distance. Let's see what they can do. Danny D-Rod Rodriguez, as expected, has come in as the quarterback. You can tell by that bright Bengal helmet. Played for the Valley Bengals. Looks like a Cincinnati Bengal helmet. And he's got a strong arm. Going up into and out of the hands of Wasi. But that was a beautiful throw and a fabulous effort by Wasi.
Yeah, nice throw, high ball, but an even greater play by the cornerback, Tanilu Lamalu. From the Ventura White, only 4'9 and 86. For them, the shutdown corner.
Tanilu
Lamalu. 4.5 minutes to play in the first half. The team in blue. The South leading here by 12-6. Again, both their touchdowns off of specialty team scores. A kickoff return by DeWasi and then the big-time punt return by DeLon Bright.
Third down.
Bright had a kickoff return call back, or he would have had another touchdown. Third down, they need six. Screen far side. The quickness of Caldwell gets him a first down in space. He's fun to watch.
Fantastic play. Well executed. Only needed 5 yards. Got six.
Well, everybody raved about Deontay Caldwell from the Lancaster Jets. Again, he averaged three touchdowns a game. He had five touchdowns over 70 yards.
Let's go pop, make it happen.
Yeah, they call him the youth version of Reggie Bush, and he looked like it right there.
I think Reggie Bush looks like Deontay Caldwell. Might have reversed the roles.
I concur.
First down. Well, right at the 34-yard line. And here's that jet sweep. And DeWasi back the other way. Wait, the ability to cut on a dime. And DeWasi is skilled.
No, he is skilled. But even more impressive were the North, you know, Isaiah Panapa, Trevor Fletcher, and Matthew Cortez. Maximus Aina causing havoc at the defensive line.
Pick up of four. It's second down and six. Clock is running. We're down to 3 minutes and 20 seconds left of this opening half. The team in blue again. That, of course, the Midget South team leading 12-6. Randy Rosebloom, Toy Cook, along with Shauna Shippen.
That's right.
Shauna working the sidelines for us today. Flag is down. It was a lot of movement, twisting and turning as DeLon Bright. That was well defended. Again, North running to the football. Matthew Cortez with the stop. We have a shift infraction against the offense.
We got a 5-yard penalty against Southside offense and a timeout.
Timeout called by the South. 2:51 left first half. They lead 12-6. Just under 3 minutes to play on the opening half. The South with it.
And there is face painting and balloons happening today.
And they're staring at a second down and 11 call.
Second down for the South.
South has utilized three quarterbacks in this first half. And Larry's back in. It's a reverse pass. Bright catches at the 39-yard line. Swanson Nunnery with a ball thrown well. It was low to the ground, but he put it in a position where only his receiver could make the grab.
Yeah, I think that was a reverse pass, right? Reverse pass, nice execution. On defense for the North was Maximus Aina from North Oxnard Red, part of that Aina family I told you about. And is David Kavika Aina, which in Samoan, David means Kavika. So we have Maximus Aina and Kavika Aina.
Timeout on the field taken by the North. They know it's third and five. They're going to try to slow down the South with 2:35 to play before intermission.
If I say South side, I want you to make some noise. Okay, let's try it. North side! Here they are.
Third and five for the South. They're making a lot of noise here at Palmdale.
Here we go, third down.
Home of the Falcons.
Southside on offense.
Falcons had another big time year in the southern section. Watts. Late flag as Watts hits it to the 42-yard line. And again, Drew Watts is a load.
He is a load, but Nico Nerez of Ventura White, nice form tackle right there.
Referee Charles Cameron will give us the call. Says holding offense.
So we got holding on the south side. Move that ball back a little bit and repeat the third down.
Yeah, it's funny. You get the sense that the South is in complete control of the game, but they're only up 6 points.
Yeah, I mean, you know, as you said earlier, they like to be a very fast team. So at any moment, they have the ability to go the distance. But the thing about the North is they're a big team. Look at them. Look how big those defensive linemen are and their linebackers. So this is an interesting matchup. Speed
for the North side
versus power.
Wait, did I say North side?
You look at number 67 on the defensive line, Kavika Aina. That looked like he's 140 pounds. Looks
Christian
much bigger
Middleton.
Than that. There's another timeout. 2:19 to play in the half. It's 12-6 for the South.
Let's do this, Christian. Love Nehemiah.
Elias Larry is the quarterback on third and 15.
Third
fakes to Watts. Larry goes down back at the 26-yard line. Boy, was he hit by Titus 22. Hutchison.
Titus Hutchison of Ventura White, 4.995. Says he can handle the end, locks down the reverse, and great pass rusher. We saw it right there.
North takes another timeout with just above 2 minutes to play in the half.
In the backfield and creating a fourth down.
Well, the North knows they're going to get the football back here. Their head coach is Rich Marshall from the Camarillo Roadrunners. Smartly calling the timeout. He's going to send Knowles Williams from the North Oxnard Gray out to return. Nunnery's punt. Remember the last one he punted? Bounced off one of the North players and the South recovered.
Yeah, if I'm the North, I'm definitely looking for that one iron. Hopefully he'll get the sand wedge out this time and get it out there. Either way, it looks like if the North is going to get pretty good field position with 2 minutes left to go till halftime.
I think the coaching staff would like to see the driver see a big, big punt. Maybe kick it over the head of Williams. And it's blocked. It'll be the North football. Breaking through to reject, it was Trevor Fletcher of the Simi Valley Vikings.
Trevor Fletcher came through one-on-one, got his hand up, the big paw, knocked it down, and the recovery was by Peyton Casillas of Thousand Oaks Titans. Good job on blocking it, individual effort, and a good job by Casillas falling down and onto the ball to recover and give the, as I said, North was going to get pretty good field position. I didn't know it was going to be that good.
Well, they'll line up in the red zone. They'll start at the 16-yard line.
Looking to find the end zone.
So a chance for the North. And quarterback Daniel Duran from the Ventura White, who's thrown a touchdown in this first half. Into the flat. Has Middleton. Middleton has the 10, the 5. He scores. Christian Middleton, we're even at a dozen.
Christian Middleton takes a screen, cuts across the field, uses his speed and quickness, vision. Nice touchdown.
And for quarterback Duran, that's two throws for scores in the first half. That one to Middleton earlier, one to Isaiah Aragon. And a chance for the North to take the lead at halftime. Minute 51 to play before the break. Duran takes off. close, but he's not quite to the goal line. He's denied. So it remains 12 apiece.
That is true. Even though the scoreboard says it is at 12 to 12.
South side.
Well, the south side still going to have nearly 2 minutes. The north scores so quickly. The South will have an opportunity here.
Well, the way that things have been happening on special teams, 151 is an eternity.
How about this? Has this been an entertaining first half?
You know what? It makes it all the worth a while for me waking up at 6 o'clock and driving out here to Palmdale, because this is what it's all about. I mean, this is fantastic. One of the kids on the South team, Max Owen Garber, he came all the way from near Santa Barbara. They were up there vacationing, and his parents brought him down just to be part of this. So that shows you the kind of dedication that these families have for their kids.
Well, the parental commitment is really great. And there really is a true benefit to play in the PYFL. They're well coached, well disciplined. As I said earlier, we met these young guys, and they were so respectful.
Yeah, these parents did a really good job. And that's one of the good things about football, you know, it teaches you dedication, responsibility, you know, being on time. So these kids are being well prepared for the future.
In the first half, with 9-12.
Good catch.
Stonehouse kicking off. It's a short kick. Eric Williams with the return, and Eric Williams inside the 40-yard line, run out of bounds at the 37. Well, we've seen Eric Williams kicking, but this time Williams showing he's fleet of foot.
Well, once again, at this level, everyone is an athlete, right? Some of these guys that are playing on the defensive line in this game could end up being quarterbacks and receivers in the future. So that's the best part about this game. You can do it all at this age.
I'm impressed with the explosiveness of the South team and the pinpoint precision of the passing game by the North. So the clock is running with a minute 35 to play in the opening half. We're even at 12. Larry's going to trot back on. Elias Larry. But he's not going to line up as the quarterback. Bright's the quarterback. Larry's on the flanks.
Wildcat.
A wildcat.
And laundry flies.
And we have more laundry. Procedure call. Yeah, the Hankies have been out here a little bit in the first half. But, again, these teams have not practiced much. And in all candor, they've performed and executed very well considering. It'll be first and 15.
So that penalty will be against the South side.
Well, the second half figures to be very interesting in a game that's very much in doubt.
Time ticking down on the first half.
Inside of a minute, and the clock is running. Bright reversing his field. Wassey with a good block downfield. He's down to the 29-yard line where he's chased out of bounds by Trevor Fletcher, the same young man who blocked the punt.
Same guy, hustles on every play. That's what we got. Has a great motor. That was the notes that we got on him. But what was even more impressive was Bright's ability to know that he had to get out of bounds to preserve time on the clock.
South is looking at second and two.
That was a run of 13 yards for DeLon Bright.
Nothing
to have. Cameron Scott, the fourth quarterback used, running the football, trying to get that first down. Going to have a timeout taken by the South. 36.8 seconds remaining. How about the South? Not only is it difficult to execute, they've rotated now four quarterbacks in there.
Yeah, no, that good job. You know, everybody wants to be a quarterback. Coach Larry has done an excellent job of getting all four guys in there. Cameron Scott, and that's Cameron with a K, better known about as a safety, but as we saw right there, has some nice running skills.
Well, he's big and fast, and he hits hard on defense, and he brings you a physical presence to the quarterback position when he runs the ball, and he was trying to get the first down. He did come up a little bit short. It's third down and about one to go.
We're also getting an assist today from Domino's Pizza. We have kettle corn available.
What's impressed you the most here so far today, Toy?
I just think when you look at the lack of practice time and the ability of all these kids to run multiple, you know, offenses from three to four wide receivers to running the plays and executing the way that they have, you know, based upon lack of practice time, I think it's pretty impressive.
I'm impressed with the passing game of the North. I didn't expect at this age level, you got a quarterback in Duran who's tossed a couple scores here. They're very adept at going up top.
Agreed.
Danny D-Rod Rodriguez looking to engineer a late drive for a score here near the end of the first half. From the 28-yard line, he's got Wassey. DeWitt Wassey with a leaping grab. A terrific play by that wide receiver. It's a first down at the 16-yard line. The Blue trying to take it in right before intermission. And with quarterback Danny D-Rod Rodriguez, you got to like his chances. And now he's starting to hook up with DeWitt Wassey. They appear to have terrific chemistry together. Another throw for DeWassey. Back shoulder job, and it's a touchdown for the Blues.
How is that for a play? How about Wassey?
And how about the throw by D-Rod Rodriguez of the Valley Bengals, who just threw a professional-type backside shoulder throw. And as you were saying earlier, what's impressed you the most?
The passing game. And you know what? This is at the end of the half, where the clock was a factor. They score with just above 23 seconds to go before the break. They get the lead. You love the execution level under control.
Under control, and like we said earlier, with 1 minute, 51 seconds, that's an eternity, and they used every bit of the clock. Very efficient, very smart, excellent job of moving down the field, passing the ball, like you said, passing the ball to get this touchdown.
Toy, what have we not seen today? No one's been able to make a conversion on these touchdowns. Here's a PAT try. Let's see if they can drive it through.
You might have gone with the reverse whammy, and we might actually might get it. We might break this.
A little psychological thing going on here. Swanson Nunnery. Come on, Swanson, you can do it.
Oh!
I knew it.
See? The reverse whammy.
Oh, there's a penalty. Don't take this away from Swanson. Did he drive? That made it by a good 8 to 10 yards.
With someone in his face. It looked like Isaiah Panapa. Panapa.
Looks like we're going to try it again. And what I love about this, here we are getting excited about a point after. You know, at the high school, even college, and certainly at the pro level, it's automatic. This is not taken for granted. And it's an exciting play.
Well, and it could be the difference between winning and losing the game. Just one play right here.
The Southern Stars with an 18-12 lead. And let's see if Swanson Nunnery can get off another great kick. Nope, it's blocked. And the play is dead in youth football. So it remains 18-12. But Swanson, that wasn't your fault. And that first kick was wonderful.
It was wonderful. And on that second kick, that was Titus Hutchinson of the Ventura White breaking in.
Doing work.
Well, you never know with 23 seconds left and what we've seen here. 18-12. We'll see if it stands up before they go into the locker room. Glad you're with us for youth football today. This has really been a great show in the first 24 minutes of action. 30 points on the board, big plays, kick returns for scores, punt returns.
I have a shout out.
We've had a block kick for the North that led to one of two touchdown passes for quarterback Daniel Duran.
On the north side. Hey, boy, you better hit somebody. Love you. You
So let's see if the North can set up a return and come back down the field. Nunnery will kick off. Swanson, by the way, is a nice receiver as well. We've seen him do all the kicking, but he can entertain you on the flanks. They go short. Of course, it's a live football. Again, there's the speed of the South getting down the field and recovering it. Reeled in by Derek Harvey.
Well, it says that Eric Williams kicked it, can place the ball anywhere on the field.
Recovers the onside kick. He leapt in the air.
Nice job by Swanson Nunnery on that kick. We might 18 seconds to go. Let's see what happens here.
South side will take a shot. North side.
D-Rod Rodriguez at quarterback. Let's see what D-Rod can do. Is that another spectacular catch?
D-Rod completes another.
Did O'Hanlon come down with it? The big O who threw the big block to free Wassey to begin the game. How about these catches that the South is making? They're in their hurry up. 3 seconds to go. This will be at the final play of the half, barring a penalty. Incomplete. But there is a marker.
Pass incomplete. Intended for Wassey.
Interference defense will have an untimed down.
Yeah, and I totally disagree with that call. That was not pass interference. The ball was not catchable. The kid was not on him. The referee made a mistake, but of course I am a defensive back, so I got to side with my DBs.
Why not? Of course, Toy Cook played in the National Football League for 11 years. You want to recite your resume?
The Saints for 7 years, the San Francisco 49ers for 2 years. We won the Super Bowl in 1994, Steve Young and Jerry Rice, and then the Carolina Panthers for 2 years.
So Toy Cook knows the game. Here's a pass. That one's incomplete, nearly intercepted in the back of the end zone by Lamalu, Tanelu Lamalu, and that's how the first half ends. There are no penalties down. We're at the break. Your score is the South 18, the North 12, in a very good midget all-star game in the PYFL.